Counselor, when we vote on things, we vote yes or no. And I hate to put you on the spot, but I need to know from you or Mr. Gruen here, yes or no. If this goes forward, is there a chance that Forsyth County could be discriminated against or prevented from getting future grants from the state of Georgia? Yes or no?
I'm a lawyer, Mr. Chairman, and yes or no is hard for me.
I know, it just doesn't gain the same billable hours.
Too stinking quick. No, and all kidding aside, it's not a surprise to me that question was going to be asked. Here's what I can do for you.
Can you give me a yes or no? Okay.
Well, wow.
It just doesn't work that way.
Yeah, no. Yes. I talked to DCA yesterday, and all right, let me just do it this way. DCA has issued us a letter. Sorry, Commissioner, yes or no is hard. DCA has issued us a letter trying to address the county's concerns with respect to the very question that you're asking.
So were you getting to the yes or the no?
Who's going to sign for everything? How are they going to do it?
Can I get my question answered first, and then you all ask another question?
It seems like the answer is that we're not responsible under general obligation, and that they're saying that we can't be responsible under the pledge of grant. However, being a non-entitled community, we don't get grants, and I think that...
Thank you for the answer, Ken.
Well, I think that's what he was trying to get to.
Was that your question?
Well, that was his question.
It was the question of the gentleman in the bow tie down there. Yeah. Go ahead and keep going on down to, you know, in my business, we simmer things down. You know what I mean? We start cooking them, and we get all the way down to the flavor.
What so flavor are we
cooking? We're cooking this down.
Even popcorn?
We're still in liquid. We'll figure a way out to do that. We're still in distillation.
The reason that answering your question is challenging is because at the end of this process, there's going to be a development agreement, right? I'm not in the restaurant business. For a lawyer, the proof is in the contract. The agreement. I don't have that yet.
Call that a recipe.
So it's challenging for me to say yes or no when I don't have the document that will tell me yes or no. All I could do was call DCA, and I looked at his letter, and I said, Mr. Williamson, the county is concerned about any liability or encumbrance on the county's bond rating, encumbrance upon our general obligation debt, our encumbrance upon our millage, any sort of encumbrance that could be financial.
We know there's no general obligation responsibility for the taxpayers, and that as you just explained, a lot of things would have to happen before we might lose some potential grant that we've never applied for, and et cetera.
This assumes, of course, that we all through this stay out of court. We've had what I would consider ironclad contracts on items before, and we end up in the court about the contract, and because of the way courts operate, we end up with in some cases approaching $1 million of trying to get the court to give us what we believe we already have completely lined up in the contract, and this opens us up to something wild and crazy like that.
I guess anything we do could lead to litigation, any decision we make.
I definitely agree.
You know, and again, we're not approving it. We're just asking to have a public hearing.
That's it. We haven't proven anything, it's just a public hearing, and we could turn it down.
Sure could.
Public hearing gets more information.
Gets more information out there, allows the development agreement to be looked at by council and all that presented. So.
We have a motion, and we have a second. Further discussion? If not, please vote on the motion. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign?
Aye.
Motion fails, 2-3.
Mr. Chairman, Counselor? I'd like to make an announcement, please.
Right ahead.
I'm going to introduce at the next work session, if I can get a second, that we review all funding that this county provides for economic development opportunities, and then we look to remove that from the budget and move it to contingency. I have a hard time when we have several issues of economic development, one of them being a restaurant that we're holding up for one person, and then this, to hold a public hearing so that a business can look to bring jobs to us, and we don't seem to want to do it. So why do we spend money on economic development? Why do we fund the chamber? Why do we spend that money? I think it's a waste of money, and I'd like to bring that forward for some discussion. Would you be okay with that?
Doesn't matter if I'm okay. If you want to make an announcement,
would you be okay with that discussion at the next work session?
You can have any discussion you want to have.
Cindy, would you put that on the next work session, then, please?
I'm not seconding your...
Well, you just said I could have it, so you're authorizing me to put it on.
That's not true, Cindy.
Do you want to have it or do you not?
You're welcome to find a second.
I'm just asking you if you think we ought to have that discussion. Why do we spend hundreds of thousands of dollars on economic development when it's obvious we're not allowing it to happen? Not even to get the information. It's not even allowing. It's just a matter of allowing information to come forward. How do we justify that to the taxpayers?
Counsel, item number 6.
I understood that he said I could have it.
And I'm telling you, I was not seconding his request to put that on there. He said he was going to make an announcement. I said he's welcome to announce whatever he wants to announce.
Well, I ask if he's
so
welcome to
in that framework of an announcement, that's what he made. If he wants to put an agenda item on, he needs to find a second. I did not second.
You're not willing to discuss
item.
It then, while we spend that
item money. Number 6, please, counsel.
Right.
Pardon me?
It just doesn't make sense to me why you don't want to discuss it. It's just odd to me, that's all.
Are you finished?
Yeah, I was just saying it was odd. You asked me what I said.
Item number 6.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, item number 6.
But this isn't why you brought this gentleman in to make this presentation.
But that came up.
It came up with it. It became a part of it.
I think maybe this came up ahead of time because somebody had the time to write it up.
Look at the date.
It came up when we were discussing it.
Look at the date.
After the agenda item was on there, it came up.
That we couldn't make a decision on it anyway.
It came up because I was requested to prepare a resolution that would allow a certain team to play on a field. And it was my job to tell the requesting party that I couldn't do that because it was not permitted. And I know contrary to popular belief, I don't like to always tell people just no. I like to tell you no with maybe an option for how you can get to where you want to be.
I thought you couldn't answer yes or no.
And I just
proved it again.
You just proved it again.
And I've got more to pinch.